Bueno, bueno, bueno. Hola. Tanyin Lee. I'm an intuitive psychic spiritual counselor, physical medium, remote viewer, automatic writer, inner child shadow work, angelic healer, and life coach. Bueno, bueno, bueno. It's Sunday. Weekend's over. Weekend is over. How's everyone doing? How's everyone doing? How was your weekend? Hello, Ashley. Hello, Shay. Y'all didn't see me much this weekend. I was taking a little bit of time off from social media. Sometimes we gotta do that, you know? Just unplug for a couple days. Or for at least 24 hours. So if y'all don't see me on sometimes, that's what I'd be doing. That's what I'd be doing. Woohoo! Well, how's everybody's weekend? Oh, thank you, Ashley. Oh, that's cool. I get to play my little man's first birthday. That's awesome. So cute. I'm going to pull out the board just in case anybody wants to do a read it forward. Remember, the read it forwards are really awesome. I'm going to throw a couple, I'm going to throw a couple charms for you and a couple cards. And I'll throw a couple charms for you and or for someone else and a couple cards as well. Nicest gift you can do is those read it forwards. DJ's doing pretty good. He's feeling a lot better. Kind of ate pretty good today. He hasn't really ate much because of the stomach cramps and stuff like that. But today he ate pretty good. Oh, there you go. I'm doing great. Thank you for asking. Y'all miss me? Y'all miss me? Not like I was really gone that long, huh? let me grab my... Alright, let me grab my... link real quick. Guys, please share out. We're going to be doing readings tonight. I'm just posting mine so we can get started. Speak of the devil, here he comes. Did you get it?
Got the wrong key. So I have to grab the gym key. That's right there.
Well, say hi to everyone.
Hey guys. How are y'all? Hope y'all are doing good.
They can't see you.
Oh, you want to say for? Hope y'all are doing good. Hope the weather is fine for y'all. Hope it's amazing. We've rained a lot lately, so. Anyways, I love y'all. And I'll see y'all later.
Maybe you come back and you can pull him a card.
Maybe not.
Maybe you pull him a card. Yeah. They're saying hello.
Oh, that reminds me. thank you guys for all y'all's prayers. I really do appreciate it. It really does warm my heart because it is kind of a problem for me. And I'm glad that y'all are supporting me and giving me love. Thank y'all so much.
He's so sweet. I think I'll keep him. Y'all can't really see. I got like Himalayan string lights for my desk, but you can't really see it. But I did turn on my dream catcher for you. He's a good kid. He really is. I tell you what, these ones with flowers are just, they're dangerous. I won't buy those again. Okay. I'd like to ask the four archangels to please step forward. Be the element of fire, Michael, to the south. Uriel, the element of earth, to the north. Gabriel, the element of water, to the west. Raphael, the element of air, to the east. Please put up a protection, white golden light around me and my circle. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the power and the kingdom and glory forever and ever. Amen. I'd like to ask God, Jesus, the Holy Spirit, archangels, guardian angels, spirit guides, and ascended masters to please step forward and help deliver messages of light and love. Ask that all messages be for the greatest and highest good and no lower level energies in our space. I'd also like to ask if any spirit would like to step through, that they may do so. As long as they are coming from positive intent, they leave the same way they came, and they leave no physical ailments on my body. I ask all this in Jesus' name. I think clearly, I see clearly, I speak clearly. Amen. Yeah, he's so sweet. Almost caught my feather on fire. Go. All right. So, man, I changed that light bulb. That's awful bright, ain't it? So, what we're doing is after every 50 shares, I'm going to give out a free card. And then at 111, I'll give away a free mini read. 144 and 222. I do have where you guys can purchase down below if you want to do a read it forward. If you don't know what that is, what it is that you buy the read it forward. I give you two charms and two cards, and then you pick somebody in the crowd to give two charms and two cards to. It's really a cool way of put that behind the crystal ball so I can see. I'm loving reading with this crystal ball. But it's really cool to give back, you know? And trust me, you get well worth your money's worth. And then if you want to just get your own personal reading, I have that. And then I am also doing a reading, plus I'll clear out your chakras with my badass new believer. This baby is bad. Look at that. Okay, baby, go right ahead. This is a Please stop. Now go right to left. Yes, giving is caring. Caring is kind. Isn't that cool? Please stop. Now go right to left. Oh, so strong. Woo-hoo. What did I pray for? Well, he's seeking the love that's already there. In my soul and focus my stare. I almost lost hope, but I didn't. I have, DJ bought me some headphones, or wireless earbuds, and I had it today, and I was just in here just belting out. I was just singing my ass off, and the JoJo comes up, Nana, no, Nana, no. It was so cute. He was like, Nana, no, no. No, no, no. Yeah, this pendulum is awesome. I'm excited to use it to clear someone's chakras. So, you know, for those of you that haven't had that, you see a big old hickamore on there? It's, yes, 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 yes. I'm excited to use that on somebody besides myself. Of course, I've used it on myself. Here comes the sun. You know, one that we pray for. And we will do a group read, so stick around, okay? Everybody will get readings on the group reading. I got some exciting news, though. I got two, actually. I got an overseas company that's coming to the U.S. asked me to be on their site. They have some clientele that have asked if they would be able to text me. So that's a text and call service. And then I was invited. And I'm kind of, I don't know what to think about this, but there's a podcast that's wanting to do an interview with me. I was like, an interview? What do you want to interview me for? So I'm very excited about that. That's coming up in February. So that's kind of cool. Hallelujah. Let's put our minds together. I know the song I was singing. I couldn't think of the song. What's going on? I said, hey, hey. And JoJo's like, no, 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 no. So, of course, I just had to belt out even louder, you know, because he told me no. Put on some. Yeah, I'm kind of excited about it. It's a wellness group of people. I mean, they're like really into wellness and spiritually and of course physically. But it's really about empowering each other, which we could use some more of that in this community. Thank you, Faith. We got our 50, so we can start giving away some readings. And we're almost about to have that support button. Ooh, only 20. Come on, guys. If everyone just in here shares at least one, you will get, we will hit that 50. Yeah. Yeah, that blonde song. That's my song. I sing that song to myself quite often. That's kind of like my pump up song. I say, hey, yeah, yeah. Because, you know, we need to pump ourselves up sometimes, you know? Things can be a little tense sometimes. But definitely looking forward to doing that. She said she had watched my life story. You know, that video I did with my life story? And that's why they want to talk with me. And I was like, really? Which is cool. I mean, maybe something good. I mean, not maybe something. Something good is coming out of all that crud. But it's really cool to, you know, for someone to reach out like that. So I'm very humbled. Oh, no, it was Moldavite oil. I use Moldavite oil. This stuff is nice and light. It's not stinky. You know, some of that oil is very stinky. It's good for, like, you know, putting in the room or whatever, but not on your body. And this one is really, really good. I have the oil is straight, and that's a big old bottle too. That's 25, and then I have the incense, which are $10, and it's straight up Moldavite. Woo! Let me get you flying. Hey, Kaylee. Hey, Susie. You could almost smell it, yeah. It'll have me going here in a little bit. Hello, hello. We're trying to get up to our 50 shares so that way I can start giving out some cards. And then we do have... Maybe you guys have to look at it. Maybe mine are... But you can find like this. On the other side, we can take the stairs to the heavens. Okay. Well, hello, Madison. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We are, there we go. We are doing readings tonight. We've got a couple different things that you can purchase down there. And I am also giving out free cards every 50 shares. My day is good. Poor DJ. My daughter took us to where she works is called Pinstripes, and they have a really fancy to doodle little brunch. And DJ was eating so light. I brought him some chocolate covered strawberries home. I said, well, maybe you'll want these in a few days. Y'all tell me something about your day. How's your day gone? How's your weekend? How was your weekend? Hello, Lisa. JoJo will, he'll let me clean his aura now with the selenite stick. When I do the selenite stick, I stand there. He brought it to me today. He was like, Nana, Nana. Oh, that's okay. Making that money. Got some stuff cleared out. Clutter cleared. That's good. It's always, always good to, when you clear out clutter, you're also clearing out your mind at the same time. You may not feel like it at the time, but trust me, you are. Work, work, work. You know, this is the first job I've ever had that I had weekends, that I'm going to have weekends off. Last week was really easy. It was just a couple hours a day. This week is down to get down to the nitty gritty, the 8 to 5, due to give birth tomorrow, so nerves and excited. Oh, congratulations. Oh, your grandson turned 10. Congratulations on the baby. Happy birthday to your grandson. Yeah, it's always nice. Life is so amazing, you know, comes in and it goes out. Was made for this. Hola. Hola, ¿cómo estás? I said you're really good, so I thought I'd watch one. Oh, thank you, Tony. I got chilled weekend with the kids, stayed warm. Oh, really cold. We were cold, and then we got up to, I don't know, like mid-60s. So it was a little too cold for the waterfall, but I'm hoping that it'll work tomorrow. Oh, no, I can't bless your best friend. I'm sorry to hear that. DJ! Let's see if I can get him in here to pull you guys a card. Okay. Hey.
Yes.
Come pull them a card. Okay. Here he comes. He's gonna pull you guys a card. From South Africa. Wow. I am in Fort Worth, Texas. Where's your cards? He's getting his cards. He's serious now. He's serious now, guys. Look at that little baby right there. Look at that little baby.
I think my toes are frozen.
Your toes are frozen?
Yeah. Time out.
Oh, I thought you were saying like you needed a time.
time out. Now, when you're a kid and you get time out, it's the worst thing possible, right? But as an adult, you see that it was a good thing that you were in time out. Now the timeout card can be pulled into two different ways. But the way I see it, I see one way. And it's that if you look at your past horrible tragedies and events, at the time, they're horrible. They're the worst things that's ever happened to you, possibly. But then when you look into it now, you're like, oh wow, even though it was tragic, it really helped me with getting closer with my family, helping with my job, you know. There a lot of stuff, almost, there's some different beliefs, but I believe that a lot of stuff happens for a reason. Not everything, but I believe a lot of stuff happens for a reason. So, there's got to be at least some that are for a reason. You're not just put here to just live, you know. If that was the reason, that would have been ancient times, or way back then. Probably Adam and Eve kind. So, just look back at your past tragedies and events and see, did it help? Did it help me with my struggles in life? And that's what the time was like. There you go.
Well, thank you.
I'll sit right there, okay?
Thank you.
I love y'all.
I like his little spin on the cards. He's got such a grown-up way of looking at things at such a young age, don't he? All right. What are we at on our shares? He took off. You know why? Because he was able to buy himself. He worked last week and he was able to buy himself that WWK 2020 or something like that. So he was very excited. All right, so let's see. We should at least be close to 50. Let me just give me some emojis, guys. Let's pull a few cards. Remember, if you want a guaranteed reading, all you're going to do is look down in the pinned comments, and there's a read up forward. That means that you'll get a couple charms and a couple cards, and then you pick someone else to get some. And then you can get your own reading, or we can clear out chakras. Be here. So do you. All right. I'm gonna pull a few cards here and let's see. I know, I love this song too. Just give me some emojis, guys. I guess there's a delay. Even on the path. Anna. Destiny, Anna. Bless your heart. You're just so worried about your destiny. You're so worried about what you should be doing and what, you know, compared to what you're doing. This is so unproductive, my love. Unfortunately, all it does is keep you further from what you should be doing. If you just kind of trust, just focus on, you know, loving on yourself and, you know, giving yourself unconditional grace and mercy, everything will fall into place. But when we are constantly worried, am I living my life purpose? Am I doing this right? Am I doing that? Or should I do this? Or should I do that? All you're doing is pushing your destiny further and further out. So Spirit's telling me for you to just relax and just stay focused on your self-growth. And then what you should be doing and where you should be going is going to come to you. It's just going to be an automatic. Okay? Let me pull you on, Kaylee. Kaylee, third eye chakra. Third eye. You want this baby to open up? Work on the heart. Work on the heart. So many people work on getting that third eye open, only to have it close a little bit later. Why? Because the heart chakra is center. It's three chakras above and three chakras below. A lot of people don't teach you this. They kind of teach you, oh, we'll just go through them, go through the chakras. No, actually, if you start with the heart and expand, the flow will go. Yes, you can unblock the other ones, but they won't stay unblocked if the heart is blocked. It just won't, because it's everything inside of the heart. Because it's the other ones are just bits and pieces of the puzzle, where the heart is the center of you, and it holds the keys to all the other chakras. Hello, Veronica. All right. Let's hit that 111 and I'll give out a three card reading. Let me see. Y'all just give me emojis and let's keep pulling a couple cards here. I know it's really strange because people will say, well, start with your root and work your way up, da da da. And you can if you're doing like a deep surgeries on your chakras, but once you get to that heart, got to get down to the nitty gritty when you get into the heart, because that controls everything. Hey Deanna, let me pull you a card, my dear. I want you to have this card, right? Relaxation. Sleep. I just see the word sleep. So are we not sleeping very restful? Are we not getting they're saying that you're not getting enough sleep. Remember, sleep is key, and you know, and it can be hard sometimes. I know I sometimes have days where just like 4 or 5 hours, and that's all I can sleep. But that's not really good on that's not really good on the mind. It's not good on the body. We all know that, but it's really, really bad on the mind. Yeah, that's what they're saying. So, you know, get you, if you know, if you don't have any, maybe get you some of that lavender spray for your pillow, or do bath, relaxing bath before bed. But you really need to get you some more sleep, they're saying. They're saying get more sleep. Yeah. Running. Well, welcome, Tony. You're welcome, Deanna. You got to figure out some way to make it happen, because you can't keep doing it like that. If you keep doing it like that, then the things are going to start getting all twisted in the head. Yeah. Ask for, you know, a good archangel for that is Raphael. Ask Raphael for a good night's sleep. Pray to him before you go to sleep. And then when you wake up in the morning, say thank you for that wonderful night's sleep. And then the next night, say, Raphael, please help me have a great night's sleep. And then wake up, you know. You got to bring things into existence and feel it. You can get my playlist on my YouTube channel. I have a lot of playlists on there. I did find, someone did send me a little tool to be able to download my videos faster, because my lives weren't getting, I haven't been updating my lives because it takes forever just to upload. But on my, the unique Tanya Lee on YouTube, there is a live list, and you can click on that, and all these songs are right there. I look myself through my third eye. Thank you, Roseanne. Yeah. All right, give me emojis, guys. Just emojis. Let's pick someone else to give a card to. Yeah. Welcome. And at the end of the live, I also go back and put up all my links, guys, where that way you're having my Awakening Your Soul. That's my personal group. You can post in there for readings, or if you like to give readings. Love you too, my dear. And then if you my website for readings, my website for joining my secret Facebook group. Dark haired cinnamon man. Wake up. Barb wants a card. Okay, Barb. All right, Barb, let's see what we got for you. Hey. Rest and rejuvenate. You're another one. You're another one not getting a lot of rest. You're just so busy. So many different things going on. Not a lot of, you do some of your spiritual hygiene, but not as much as you should. The problem is somebody like you, you'd have to get up and give up a little bit of sleep just to get that private time. But it might be worth doing a couple times a week where you just get up an extra, you know, 30, 45 minutes early. Or stay up a little extra later. But have you not been meditating as much as you normally? Yeah. Have you been not meditating as much as you normally do? Because I see the word meditation. You guys have to get sleep. You have to get sleep. It's very, very important to get sleep. Sleep is what rests the mind. I mean, not really, but it's connected to the body. And I mean, because our mind's still going. That's why we dream. But yeah. Well, then drop the kids off, and then get up earlier, meditate, then go drop the kids off, and then come back to sleep. Yeah. You need to do some meditations, baby, even if you got to do those shower meditations, you know. Or, you know, the 5 minutes of the song in your ear or something. But we got to be doing those 5-6 minute meditations every single day, guys. That's got to be a priority. Now, those big 30, 45 minutes, you know, type of meditations, those you have to kind of, have to cut time out for. But those 5-6 minute ones, you don't. You can do that. You can do that quite often. What's our shares at? We hit 111. I'll do a 3 card. There's so many ways to meditate, though. You don't have to do that boring music. You can meditate to listening to that kind of music. You can meditate when you're writing. You can meditate drawing, coloring, painting, yard work, gardening, dancing, singing. Everybody just tries to focus on this. And I'm not saying that's not bad meditation. It's good meditation a couple times a week or more if you like it. But everybody focuses on that kind of meditation, and you're not going to get there. You're not going to get that. It's like a muscle, just like when you go to work out. You're working out, right? You're not going to be able to lift, you know, 100 pounds, you're not even going to be able to lift 50 if you haven't been working out. You're going to have to start out with 10 pounds and then 20 and then, you know, and then you stretch that muscle. People say, well, I can't meditate because when I'm meditating, a thought comes. Well, of course the thought comes, and that's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. Let the thought pass. And you bring yourself back to center. The fact that you recognize that you had a thought and you were able to bring yourself back to center means that you're making progress. So it's awesome. So personally, those 5-6 minute meditations a few times throughout the day will help pep you back up and help ground you, or help, you know, keep you in your space. And then if you want to set time out, a Saturday, I don't know if I'm going to do it just yet, but they have a meetup. And you guys should check this out in your area, too. But they have meetups. Down, it's not very far from here. And they get together and they do a meditation outside. I might try that. Go meet mind-like people. But if you like to do it by yourself, that's fine too. But just don't set that expectation. Everybody sets that expectation, and it's just, you beat yourself down before you can even attain it. Like, yeah. I like candles and incense. What'd she say? I like candles, incense, and relax. And listen to meditation music or rain music too. Yeah. If you just focus on breathing, that's why they tell you to focus on breathing. You know why? Because your mind is going to focus on the breathing, not on the thoughts. I mean, if you really are like feeling your body and you're really deeply paying attention to that breathing, you'll be able to do it a lot better. All right, give me a emoji. I think everybody just puts too much expectation of perfection on themselves. You know, you take you from the 3D and bring you over here, but you're still in the 3D mentality. It's like, you know, you see all these people, you know, on a live or on their pages or doing these shows or whatever, and they look like they're doing it all perfectly, and none of us are perfect at it. Nobody's perfect at it. Just people are vibrating at different levels. That's all the difference is. But if you put it in your mind, oh, I can't do that, then you're right. You sure in the hell can't. You can't do it if you say you can't. How many of you guys have seen The Secret on Netflix? How many of you guys have seen that show? Y'all need to. You gotta listen to it all the way around. Because I know from working with people that people will do bits and pieces of that law of attraction, but they don't do it all. Yeah, it's awesome. It's about the law of attraction, and it's not just about putting out there, sending out the vibration of what it is that we want, but it's also visualizing it, feeling it, speaking it as it comes into existence. I tell you guys to do this all the time, so it was really kind of cool to watch. I watched some of it before, but not completely, because I wasn't in a space to be able to pay attention. And then I went back and I watched it over the weekend. And it's really, really important that you visualize what it is that you want, and to actually feel it like you already have it. What would that feel like? And then to put that out there, because, you know, so visualize yourself as meditating. You know, I mean, not everything has to be this grand. I want a brand new car, and I want, you know, $100,000, and I want this, and I want that. You know, but you can't just say, well, I want this. You have to, you also have to do stuff. This is a problem. People think, well, if I just put it out there, then it's going to come to me because I put it out in the universe for it to come to me. And that's not how it works. You have to, you put it out there, but then you have to do your part, right? You have to do your part. And it's really a really, really great show. If y'all haven't seen it, please do. It really is a great, I think it's like an hour and a half long or something like that. It's not super long. Yeah. Abundance is having what I need, not what I just want. That's right. And wealth is not all about money. That's what a lot of people mess up. That's where people mess up. They're like, oh, I want wealth. And they're so fixated on money, but they don't even realize they have wealth. Because they're fixated on the dollar. They're fixated on that dollar. Instead of, hey, you have your health, you have a place. That's one of the key things too, is if you're not showing gratitude, it doesn't make a shit what you're going to put out there. The universe is not going to pay much attention to you. Because if you're not grateful for what you have, then you're not going to put out that energy. You're going to put out desperation, right? I try to tell you guys all the time, when you are desperate and say, oh man, I really need some money. Oh man, I really want that relationship. Oh man, I really want to be in love. Oh man, I really want to be a psychic. Oh man, and you're desperate. I mean, you just so want it so, so, so bad. That puts you in desperate mode. When you get in desperate mode, works against you. Works against you. Pushes it away from you. Desperate mode is the worst mode to be in. If you catch yourself in desperate mode, take a step back, breathe, say, oh shit, help me get out of this. Because that's the worst spot to be in, is desperate mode. Desperate mode will screw your life up every single time. You know, people say, well, you know, why am I always attracting, you know, why am I always getting these guys and they're no good, or this relationship's no good? Well, a lot of that has to do with how you feel about yourself. And, you know, quit looking at every single person that you go out on a date with or meet. Oh, that could be the one. One of the main, this is why I don't do my pendulum questions very much. I only do them once in a while, because I end up getting frustrated, because so many people come at me with, you know, I met this guy the other day. Is he the one? Is he my soulmate? Oh, is he going to call me back? I mean, just it draws out so much desperation from people. And I don't like that, because it sets you guys up for failure when you're desperate. Don't be desperate. You're gonna have to, if you really want to get somewhere in this whole process, you're gonna have to get to the point where you actually understand that there is enough for everybody. There's enough people, there's enough love, there's enough money, there's enough there's enough of everything. There is no scare, there's nothing scarce. There you go, that's good. Because if you go out with somebody and, you know, you have a good date and everything, and you may not be saying that, you know, but your energy, you're projecting desperation. If, you know, depending on how you handle yourself. And the only way you're not going to be desperate is to be okay with yourself. Is to love yourself and say, you know what? I'm happy. I'm happy to go to dinner with somebody, and I'm happy to go to dinner by myself. You know what I mean? I don't have to go on a date to go have dinner. I don't have to go on a date to go see a movie. I am okay. But a lot of people aren't like that, right? And then they meet somebody, and maybe they've gone out with them a month or two, and they're like, oh, is this the one? What the hell are you going to know in a month or two? I mean, the objective of having a relationship is to build a friendship. Even if it's a partner, it's still about building a friendship, because all that honeymoon sex and all that blow your mind stuff will eventually fade. There will come a time in throughout our life and that those bits and pieces of us no longer work. So then what do we have to rely on? You know? That's why it's important to build that friendship foundation. So there's so many people think that it's just about, you know, telling the universe what you want. That's why I'm telling you guys, go watch that show, because it breaks it down a little bit more. And you have to be in gratitude. You have to be in a mind frame that you have it, you own it, it's yours. You have to be in a self-love mode. You know, you can't expect to have anything work in your favor if you don't love yourself. Wealth is not how much money you have or the type of car you drive. Wealth is how many friends do you have? Do you love yourself unconditionally? That's the most richest people in the world. Why do you think really big gurus, I mean like real gurus, you know, like Moji and people like that. Why do you think they're so happy? They don't ask people for money and stuff. They don't, you know, they know that the universe is going to take care of them, right? And they're happy because they're that much, they're flying at a whole nother level. But still, they know that it's all about just loving, just love, just love. But everybody thinks that they're not going to be complete unless, you know, they're accepted by this crowd or this group, or, you know, they have a mate or their family accepts them, or even their children accept them. You know what I mean? It's all misleading. It's all misleading. Nothing's going to fall into place completely until you love yourself to that degree. And it's hard, especially if you haven't before, or you don't even know what unconditional love is. Unfortunately, so many of us, we don't know what unconditional love is. You know what I mean? And how do you know what unconditional love is if you never got it? That was something I had to learn to do for myself. And it was hard because you don't have that example. Because our parents didn't love themselves unconditionally. It's just kind of like the new thing to talk about now, right? As more and more people tap into enlightenment and they start learning and picking up books and reading and coming to groups and coming to lives and things like this, is now where it's starting to unfold. So that's why it's really important to focus on the kids. You know, get yourself in check. Get yourself in love with yourself. And then love, even if you don't have kids, find some kids to go and unconditionally love. You know what I mean? It's go volunteer somewhere, you know, Go love on a family member's kid, something, but show unconditional love to the children. So that way we can break the cycle. Everybody's talking about... Okay, I'm going to touch this. Everybody talks about domestic violence, about abuse, about emotional abuse, about rape. And all those are terrible things. Those are terrible, terrible things. But the most biggest problem we have in the world is the lack of knowledge about self-love. That's the biggest cause of addiction, abuse, on all major levels, is the lack of knowledge about unconditional love. That is the key thing that if we want to make some changes in this world, everybody can talk shit about all the different politics you want to, or, you know, talk about this or talk about that, but none of it matters without love. But it's not just, oh, I love you. No. Unconditional love. Trust me, even in this realm, let me tell you from experience, you will come across people that will say they love you, but they do not unconditionally love you. Unconditional love is very rare to find right now. And that's where all of our focus should be, in trying to get there. Because once you love yourself unconditionally, it just automatically flows out of you. You don't have to work at it. You don't have to say, okay, today I'm going to try really hard to unconditionally love people. No, because your mentality, you flip the script. It's no more, oh, maybe I love you. No, it's going to be automatically, I love you, man. Do I know you? No, I ain't got to know you. But when I say I love you, trust me, it's legit, because it's unconditional. I'm not going to throw you away, throw you to the trash the first little chance I get. People say, oh, I love, and I love you, and I love you. But where are they when times get tough? You think just because we're in this realm, or just because we're enlightened, or just because we have, we meditate, and we're talking to angels and spirits and shit like that, doesn't mean that people aren't going to have differences of opinions or differences of ways of doing things? Of course we are. But that doesn't mean we throw each other in the trash, right? Sometimes it's just, you know, agree to disagree. But minding your ability to agree on something doesn't mean shit. That's what's called unconditional positive regard. Unconditional positive regard means I respect you and your opinion and how you see things. Doesn't mean I agree with it. And more than likely, I don't. But I respect your ability and your wanting to, you know, feel and think that way. That's where people stop. We see it all in the world. We see it in politics, right? There was a good example of this on that show. They were talking about politics, and why does a person that seems to be the worser of the two candidates always win? Not always, but, you know, will win, right? Because everybody's focusing the energy on against it. Or focusing, I mean, it's that battle. So that battle is the same thing as being desperate. When you set out that battle, you might as well admit that you're just desperate, because it's the exact same thing. That's why there's so much of that. But even in, and I'm not going to get in a political debate, but people lose friends over who they like for president, or, you know, that they're a part of a religion. You know how many friends I have that are still involved? I work at a church. I'm not a member of that church, but I don't have to be a member of that church to be a part and help feed the community. I don't have to be a member of that church to do that. I love and respect those people and what they believe. And I'm able to be there as me. Now, you know. So, we don't have to, like, shove our nose up that, you know, because I think this way, or I think that way, or you don't think this way, or you don't think that way. But that's what we're teaching the kids. And then we wonder why our kids have so much hatred. We wonder why we have shootings everywhere. We can debate all day long about gun control and rights to bear arms or not, or no rights to bear arms and all that bullshit. It doesn't even matter. Because we're all coming from this place of me. That's not self-love. That's selfishness. And until we kind of come to terms with that we don't have it right, and we admit that we have it wrong, only then are we going to be able to do something to change it. But as long as there's a bunch of us, even in this spiritual realm, you would think here in the spiritual realm there would be more togetherness, and there's really not. It's just as divided as politics. It really is. You know, you have your groups, you have your cliques, and, you know, so if we really want to bring about change, then we have to kind of break free from that kind of stuff, and just love people. Good, bad, or indifferent, you know what I mean? Yeah, well, people's truth are their truth, you know? Universal truth is great. But doesn't mean shit if you're not doing nothing with it in the world and making changes. I think they'll be just fine. I mean, you know, he's got enough money. He can do what he wants to do. You know, they'll be just fine. He doesn't have to do any of that. Actually, I think it sets a good precedent because, you know, it's time for change, you know? Just like the comment, and I'm going to go there, just like the comment about the news. Well, okay, sure, they're going to tell us what we want to hear because we let that shit happen. You know? I mean, if everybody donated $5, it's sick of the fake news, to help open up a news station that delivers universal truth, as you call it, then why isn't it done? This is where I have problems. Because we're all quick to point that finger and say what's wrong, but there's no solutions here. Nobody's offering to make a solution. And we have to make a solution. And the only solution is love. Unconditional love. Now, that does... It will take money and programs and ways to put it into place and get it to working. But you have to put something in there. You have to try to do something. You can't just say, well, the media does this, or the president does this, or the school system does that, or, you know, blah, blah, blah. All the different things. Everybody, you see, we're in the same trap. It's no different. Bitching and pissing and moaning about something that, whether you agree with it or disagree with it, means nothing. But sending out the fucking bad vibrations is bringing it all back full circle. That's crazy. But that's all it's doing. That's all it's doing. All it's doing is sending out that bad vibration back out. whether you agree with it or disagree. If you agree with it and you're fighting against the people that don't agree with it, or you disagree and you're fighting against the people that do agree with it, that conflict does nothing but just make everything stay as it is. That's all it does. And meanwhile, you have children sitting around watching us all act this way, and they still aren't learning how. What the hell's teaching them to love unconditionally? You're going to teach them how to love unconditionally, but yet you're going to talk shit about your neighbor because they voted for a president, or they don't believe this, or they don't believe that, or they're a part of a religion, they're a part of this, they're a part of that. Come on, kids ain't stupid, man. Kids, watch us. You can sit there all day long tell your kids, don't do this, don't do that. But if they're watching you and that's what you're doing, then at the end of the day, all you're doing is you're molding a rebellious child. That's what you're doing. That's what molds rebelliousness, because they know you're full of shit. They know that you're two-faced. They know you're one way out in public, but in at the home, let's say, you know, you're around your family, or you go to, you know, and you come across this way, but then when you go home, you're over there talking shit. You don't think your kids aren't watching that and going, hmm. So you're building that resistance against you. Instead of pulling them close and say, you know what? These are two different ways of looking at things. This is how I feel. I don't agree with how they feel, but I respect them and their opinion. Now you're teaching them how to give unconditional positive regard. Now you're teaching them how to love their neighbor, you know? Everybody's walking around, that's right, Kelly, everybody's walking around with all this anger and shit, and then they're upset because they don't have a good job, they can't get out of debt, they don't have a partner, you know? And it's not easy. And some days it sucks. And some days we're not as positive as we need to be. And that's okay. That's the other thing. You can show grace and mercy. Not complaining. I'm trying to shed truth like you are. Like the fires. It brings compassion. We contribute to rebuild. I do give my services away, honey, and I'm not offended at all. In fact, that's what I said. I'm totally about everybody's different opinions. It doesn't bother me at all. And I do give I do give service away quite often. But I also know the laws of the universe, and I know that energy exchange is important. But it's just something to think about, you know, especially for us parents, you know. Let's try to focus on giving them, you know, if you disagree with what is being shown in the media or what's going on in a certain something, then sit down and talk with the kids about it. You know what I mean? And say, you know what? This sucks. This happened. And, you know, try to mold them into respecting the differences, you know? Because that's key. I mean, that's what's wrong with everything, right? You can't respect the differences. We got to smart off. Somebody says something against what we're saying, then somebody's got to smart off, right? Or somebody's got to beat somebody down because of how they love or who they love or what they love, right? And at the end of the day, we're, at the end of the day, we're just going on what we think is right. We don't really know. People, yes, for those of you like me that have traveled and seen things, actually traveled and seen things, or you see and speak, you know, see spirit, you know, we know that that exists, but at the end of the day, we really don't know as much as we think we do. So we just have to, we just have to do the best we can. But if we always do it from a place of love, then we can't go wrong. We may not get it right. I didn't say we were going to be right all the time. I didn't say we were going to be perfect. I didn't say everything would be hunky-dory and a bed of roses. But if we always try to come from a place of love, regardless, then we're doing something right. And to me, that's what's important to teach the kids. And we're not. And in fact, many people are just, you know, breeding more and more killers. And not killers with gun, bam, bam, bam. Killers of other people. Because what? Not one person that abuses somebody, rapes somebody, or kills somebody, or bully somebody, not any of those people love themselves. And the world's not worse than it once was, and you just can see everything now. Before, we couldn't see everything all over the world. But anyway, so there we go. Spirit, blah, 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 blah. Anyway, that's my message. We should really try to focus on self-love and teaching children to love themselves. And do you not know the impact that you could bring? Only 15 shares to go, and I'll give out a free read. If a child knows, because children know, because they unconditionally love until something happens and cuts that off, right? But even then, they are still somewhat connected. It's not until their mid-teens or something, or early 20s, that cord gets to, unless something, but anyway, my point is, if a child knows that you've struggled with certain things, or that you were angry at these people, or angry at those people, or you know, you were racist, or, you know, a bigot, or whatever you want to call it. And then they see you do that work, and they see you go inward, and they see you work on yourself, and they see you better yourself and be this different person. Do you not realize the impact and change that you can make for your children? People say, well, I love my children. Do you? Because if you truly love your children, you will love yourself unconditionally so you can love them unconditionally. And then you'll be that parent that will love and support them through anything and not turn your back because it might be something that, you know, that you don't want them to do or want them to love. You know? So, anyway. Just something to think about. You know, I know that's my mission. My mission is to be the ripple effect. To help you grow madly in love with yourself so you can be the best person you can be. That is my mission statement. And it's not easy. But it is so worth it. yeah, I remember watching her wedding. That was such a beautiful wedding. All right, let's go ahead and do some emojis, and I'll give out a 3-card reading to somebody. What's my time? I got air and water and love. I've got air, water, and love. Sometimes I tell myself, when I need to make my gratitude list and it's been a shitty day, I have clean water to drink, I have fresh air to breathe, and I have people who love me. Maybe my day's shit and I don't really notice anything else, but I can at least say that. Okay. And then we'll do a group reading. Oh, thank you, Anna. Jennifer Smith, thank you so much for being a top fan. If you guys don't know, just commenting and liking my posts on my page will get you a top fan badge. I think that's kind of cool. And then I'm going to do a group reading as well. Obstacles and challenges. Some of these cards, there's like 72 cards here, and some of these just keep popping out. You know, I'm just going to say this. This is one of those other things that if we just kind of accept that there's always going to be an obstacle and a challenge. There's always going to be one. It's not going anywhere. Even if you conquer the one that's in front of you, 5-10 miles down the road, there's going to be another one. But if you just say, you know what? It's okay. I got this. And then, we do want to look for whatever the lesson is in it. But the less grip it can have on us, because anything that you fear or anything that you, anything you fear is going to have a grip on you. And many challenges test our fear, our faith. And if it tests our faith, that means it's because we're afraid of something. Because if we have faith, then we're not afraid of shit. So, we can't have faith and fear. We have to pick and choose. We can't have both. That's why I say do it afraid. Do stuff afraid. Fake it till you make it. Not that being a fake person. I mean, fake it. Like, I got this. I'm doing this. I can do this. I can do this. And you just keep telling yourself. And I call that fake it till you make it. Why? Because we're not in that spot. That's not our reality yet. But we are putting it out there. We are making it our reality. We are creating it to be our reality. And it will be our reality because we make it. Oh, I don't remember. I was young. I don't remember how old I was. All right. You got this, girl. Don't worry about that obstacle. Happy New Year. Okay. Let's do a group reading. One, two, three, four, five, six. I'm drawing seven cards for the collective here. This is for all of you. Stick around, I promise you, it will make sense. Y'all saw, I just shake. I say that because I've been yelling this all night, and that's the card that came out. Self-love. It all starts and ends with love. It all starts and ends with love. And without it, doesn't matter, you know, how much money or anything. They say that some of the poorest people are the happiest people. That, does that ever make you wonder why? I mean, does it really have to be that way? No. But when all you have is love and you don't have other things, then you appreciate it. But when you have all the things and you don't have love, you don't appreciate love. Balance. Balance is key. But we also need this before we try to be in relationships. It's really, really important to quit trying to go out there and find someone. You know? Don't go. I mean, you have to make yourself available for someone to come along. But you need to be in the right frame of mind. If you're not in the right frame of mind, then why are you going out there? Why are you dating? And this is the direction Spirit wants me to take this, you know. And even those of you in a relationship, you know, you have to be okay with yourself so you can be best for your partner. You know, we don't just arrive at this self-love spot and we just stay there. No, it's like anything. You have to keep working at it. Right? That's why we have spiritual hygiene. That's why we meditate. That's why we ground. That's why we protect. That's why we do our aura. This is why we do those things. So if you do the work and you get to this self-love spot, and then you're like, okay, cool, I got this shit, I got it. But yet, you slack off on all your spiritual hygiene, guess where you'll be? You'll slide right back. Self-love isn't just something that just stays there. Because if you don't, then it'll turn into ego and it just goes the wrong way. So even if you have a relationship or you're looking for one, we still got to stay in purpose. Stay in service. You hear the song? You got to stay that way. But to do that, you have to be in love with yourself. And there's nothing wrong with that. But remember, being in love with yourself does not give you a license to go hurt people. I'm speaking my truth and da-da-da. No. If you're hurting people by what you speak, you're not speaking your truth. You're being vindictive. You're being cruel. Truth is not cruelty. There's always a nice way to say a negative thing. You need to have some patience with yourself. Patience. If you don't have patience, that's going to be the worst thing. I used to be the worst at impatience. I mean, I ran a restaurant. And, you know, we had so many minutes for everything. I ran Taco Bueno for 9 years almost, and we had a timer. So we had, from the time that you said your order at the box to where you drove off, we had a minute. We had a timer in the window, it goes dee 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 every 5 seconds, dee dee dee. And you talk about, I was the most impatient person because everything was go, go, go. I had somebody on the headset making the food. I had another person making the drink. I had another person doing this. It was go, go, go. It took a long time for me to come out of that. And because when I went to the restaurant, and here I am 15 minutes, 20 minutes for a plate. And I'm like, come on. What is going on? What's taking so long, you know? And then I go from that to going from, you know, that to going to working at home. And it's like, whoa. So I really had a hard lesson with patience. But don't pray about patience. Because if you pray about patience, then all kinds of tests will come your way. You're going to get tests anyway. Right? To build the muscle. Don't bring on extra. It's kind of like, don't ask for extra work because you're already going to be given work. Just take on what is coming. Use your intuition. Use your intuition. Because intuition, quit saying, oh, I knew better. I did this. You know, sometimes we don't want to feed into it, right? Because we're like, oh man, I've got to be wrong. Surely that person isn't what I'm feeling. And you fight it, and you're like, I'm gonna be nice. I'm not gonna be judgmental. That's where we fuck up right there, because it's not being mean or judgmental. It's using your intuition. Because you can politely step away from anything. You don't have to be mean, right? But if your gut feel or your intuition told you, then you are going to get whatever you get, and you deserve it. Just like I deserve when I go against mine. I have several times being in this realm, and I know better. But I've done it. So I deserve whatever I get. That's why, you know, I'm just like, okay, lesson learned. Thank you very much. Have a nice time. You know? But listen to that intuition. Learn how to discern. I mean, it's fine coming to somebody for, you know, assistance and readings and things like that. But there has to come a time that you do this for yourself. The worst thing you need is a reader trying to make you dependent upon them. Like, you can't do nothing without them. If you're around a reader like that, you need to run. And there's a lot that do that because it's guaranteed cash. You know, there's certain ways to do readings to, you know, lead people in. And it's not right. It happens. But if you listen to that inner voice, that gut feel, and you discerned, then you would save yourself a lot of heartache. A lot of emotional loss would be missed. This card would not be here as frequently. Does that mean that we still make poor choices or bad decisions? Yeah, of course we do. We're not going to be spot on 100% because we're human. So we are going to screw up. And that's okay. You screw up, you get up, shake your ass and get to walking. Base chakra. Part of the spiritual hygiene. Right? Just going outside and breathing. I mean, if you can do all the visuals of, you know, the roots down in the, or your feet going down to the ground and roots and all this dramatic stuff, that's fine. Every once in a while, I do those kind of meditations for grounding, but not very often. You know why? Because I don't need to. I go outside. I stand in that freaking sun and I feel it and I allow it to touch my skin and I soak it in. and I breathe in the air, and I put my feet in the dirt, and I let my feet get dirty. I'll lay on the ground. I'll roll on the ground. You know? Only then we can go and reach out for spiritual union. You know, I mean, not every person that you're running around here having sex with or going out on dates with is this person. Quit looking for every person to be the one. Quit looking for the one, and the one will come, will find, you will find each other. Because if you're focusing on your vibration, then you're going to vibrate where that person is. But if you're down here and you're in this desperate state, do you know what you attract? You have this, people say, do I have a victim on my forehead? Actually, you do. You have it. You have this big old hat on and it's blinking all different colors. And it's like, victim, victim, victim. And what does that attract? The narcissist. Oh, looky there, looky there. Oh, looky here. This one's been abused and used. All I got to do is tell her a couple pretty things in her ears and give her some compliments, and she's going to be goo-goo gaga. And then I can get in there and voila. But if you're vibrating, you don't have that hat on. And then that's when you try it. That's when you really, really... Okay, that's when I will in just a second. That's when you'll really conquer, because now you're in a relationship because you found a friend, and that friend has developed into your best friend, and then your soulmates. Everybody's like, oh, I want my twin flame, you know, I want, we have this battle. No, you just like drama. You just like drama. You just like drama because that's all you're asking for. But if you really want to triumph in a relationship, if you really want this spiritual union, then you're going to have to, you know, do your spiritual hygiene. And the main one, this one, there should be no reason why anybody doesn't do this a day. I mean, it makes no sense not to ground at all. It really makes no sense to not do any of them once you are educated and you know. But this one, not doing this daily is like telling Gaia, fuck you. You can't give a little bit of 2 or 3 minutes of just respecting the air that you're given to breathe or the ground that you have to walk. Got to deal with our pain, but we'll save a lot of pain if we just listen to our intuition and we use patience as we learn to love on ourselves. Okay, so they said check my PayPal. Did somebody do a reading or something? Oh yeah, here we go. I don't know why, but that's what some of y'all must be really been thinking a lot about a relationship, because that was heavy on relationship. And I usually don't do much relationship. Ooh, okay. Ooh, I'm excited. Here we go. All right. We are going to do a chakra clearing. Yee! Alright, let me get your cards ready first. My, my, my. Get these twisted. There we go. What happened? That's awesome, Deanna. I tell you what, me and my husband being best friends saved us from parting ways many times, because no relationship is perfect. Anybody that makes you think that their relationship is perfect, but the friendship will keep that relationship together in the imperfect times. Did Tammy, I got Angela. Tammy did one too, for a personal. That's right. That's perfect. That's what me and my husband were. I'm sorry, guys. You have to tell my team down there that you paid. Okay, there's Tammy. Okay. I have Angela for a paid reading as well, for a chakra clearing. Angela Jones. Let's do Tammy's. Tammy. Looks like Tammy's was down, I think first. I don't know. I see her. I don't see Angela. Alright, our first card for you, Tammy, is Firm Foundation. Firm Foundation. This is something you're working with. I mean, you're trying to do a firm foundation. You know, and I've felt this with you before, and I think I've told you. There's somebody around you that's trying to prevent this from being complete. What you're trying to build, there's someone around that should not be a part of it. But they've been around for a long time, so there's like a sense of loyalty to it. But you can still be loyal to people and not be around those people. You know what I mean? You can still have that friendship. You can still have that relationship. Even if they're not of loyalty, you can still have that and love them, but you just keep them over there because they're the weak link. They're the weak link. And we got memories of love. our fond memories kind of keep us in things longer than we should sometimes, because we remember what things were. And that, spirits tell me that's what you do a lot of. You're remembering the past, and you're remembering how things once were. Not that things can't go back there, but it takes two people to want to do that. With our, doesn't matter if it's a personal relationship, a friendship, family, it takes two people to make things work. Not one person can make everything work. You got some deceit and envy going on. Definitely some deceit and envy. Are you in a jealous relationship? Are you in a jealous relationship, Tammy? Hey, Edna. Are you in a... Sorry, guys. I don't really pay attention much to the comments while I'm reading. But hello to the guys coming in. Do you have some jealousy issues going on? No? Okay, well, if you don't now, you will have. Keep an eye out for this. Keep an eye out for this, because as you see, the person is wearing a mask. So usually with these kind of things, it's one thing for... Okay, is it you? Because the problem with jealousy is jealousy will turn into envy over a period of time due to being away so long. Yeah, and that's understandable, because I know that you travel for work, but I mean, you don't want to have that be an issue in the relationship. Either you can do it or you can't. You can either trust or you can't. If you have to take a really good look at that. Is it trust because that person's given me reason not to trust? Or is it trust because of my insecurities? Or is it a little bit of both? Because sometimes people give us a reason not to trust them, and they cause us insecurities, right? Yeah. So we just want to keep that in check, because that's what can ignite the passion, is taking that away. That's what's disrupting your foundation. And you want this passion between the two, right? You want passion between the two of you. And it's real easy to, you know, ignite that flame. But the flame will go out if the wind is blowing. If the wind is blowing, the flame's going to go out. So what do? You build that foundation around the flame, so that way it doesn't blow out. That's called security. You build that security around that flame, so that way it'll keep burning. This will help with the transformation. This would be a big transformation for you, because it's something that you do, you know, you've been doing, and to overcome it will be like a really, 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 it'll be a game changer. It'll totally change the whole game. Everything will change completely. Things will not be the same. But remember, you have to have patience and you have to plan it. So what do I mean by plan it? So those times that it triggers you, first you gotta admit there's an issue. And then you find out, well, what's the foundation and what does it stem from? And then once you know that, then have a plan for certain triggers. Have a certain response that you're going to tell yourself that you're going to do when that trigger happens. Now remember, not all triggers can be avoided, but most of them can. And have patience with yourself, because you'll do good and then you'll slip up, and then you'll do good and you'll slip up. But that's like anything, right? I mean, we're going to slip up, because we don't do anything perfect the first time. You tell me one thing anybody's ever done the first couple times and they've been perfect at it. Never. Then it'll bring some fulfillment and wishes. This will be a big, like I said, it's a big transformation. But make sure that you're having patience and planning with yourself. And then it'll keep you in the light. You know what I mean? You'll be able to stay focused in the good and not the dark. And then you will be moving on. And moving on, you know, just because you see the moving on card doesn't mean that it's move on from someone. Sometimes we just move on with life. And we leave all the past shit that's caused some issues back there. And then we just move on and go forward from here. So move on. But it's going to take some work for both parties. I really think this is starting to become a big issue. But we want to stay on the positive side. That's what this card is saying. Stay on the positive side of things. You're going to get your fulfillment and wishes, but you're going to have patience and plan on how you're going to address situations. You're going to have to make a transformation within yourself and with this person. There's things that they're doing that help trigger too. So this isn't just, oh, you have to fix something. Both of you have to fix something. You have to be a team and say, okay, you know what? I love you. You love me. We're a team and we want to conquer this. Here's what we do. Everybody's got a role to play. That way you're igniting your passion back, and we're doing something with this here. Because if we keep the jealousy and stuff inside, and we can bring about actions that shouldn't even come about, all because it's infesting. It's kind of like an infection. It just oozes out. Because we don't need memories of love. We need to have love now, here in the present. That's what will bring about the firm foundation. But this is like anything, you know, you can overcome anything put in front of you. You know, you were going through something before this. I mean, we always overcome. There's nothing that we can't overcome. It just feels like it sometimes, but doesn't mean that it's true. Yeah. Sit down and really figure out why. Start with the whys. And then ask. You're welcome. And then ask, you know, when you get a why, you get an answer, you ask a question, why? Why am I doing this? And then you get that answer. Then ask a why for that. And then keep asking that why until you get down to the nitty gritty. Because it's in when that nitty gritty that you realize, oh shit, that's now makes sense. But the problem is, some people, you get one or two answers and you leave it alone. You're like, oh, okay, I'm good with that. But no, you want to keep asking. You want to keep asking that why. You know, be like that. When you're dealing with problems and digging deep in your soul, you want to be like that 3 and 4 year old that says no matter what, it's always like, why is the sky blue? Why is this? Why is that? And then you finally get down to the foundation. But you're very welcome. My pleasure. I guess I will have to do... Angela Jones, are you here now? There's more whys I haven't asked. I said only with a couple answers. Yeah. I can definitely get her tomorrow. Because I'll come live again tomorrow. But how long have I been on? I think I've been on. And I'm sorry it took so long, Tammy. I didn't realize you had. Are you okay with me doing you tomorrow? Only because I know I've been on quite a while. There you go. You are patient. Only an hour? Really? Okay. I finish work around 5:30, so around 7. Two hours. Okay, I started to think, man. I'm at this song. I know it's been a while. I'm supposed to cut them off at an hour and a half. But yes, so what I'll do is I'll come on between 7:30 tomorrow, okay? No. The Secret. Yeah, it's not a scary movie. It's got some really good authors and philosophers and preachers and all kinds of people on there. Linda Nichols. I think that's Lisa Nichols. I think it's her name. Love her. Love, love, love her. It kind of comes from my kind of background. But yes, so we'll be on tomorrow night, okay? Please come check out the group, Awaken Your Soul. If I didn't get you here, you can always post in there. And if someone's drawn to you, they can read for you in there. If you're a reader, you can read over there. There's just some simple little rules, nothing big, no dark, no prices, no PMs. Advertise on Mondays and Wednesdays. So Monday is advertising day. So you can advertise anything but a group. And that means anything. So you guys that are crafty, that you're making stuff, or you sell crystals or whatever, go ahead and post it in there, okay? Just don't put no prices and don't ask people to PM you, okay? And of course, no dark. Please like and follow the page, and make sure you turn on notifications when I go live, because I will be going live all week. All right, except Wednesdays. Wednesdays I don't go live. Very rarely, because I'm already at work. Two jobs that. So now it'll be two jobs that day. And then, if you would like to be a member of my secret Facebook group, please go to TanyaLee.com. Check on that. It's memberships from $1 up to $24.99. Also, if you want a private reading, that would be where you'd look. Okay? Love you guys. Thank you so much for your time and energy and allowing me to let spirit kind of ramble through me. I love you. Hasta luego. Dios quiere. I'll see you later, God willing. Adios. Buenas noches.